Estava ao City. One of the populous cities in our country. It is also known as the Durian Capital of the Philippines and home to Mount Apo, the highest mountain in the nation. Currently, the city has its own mayor named Rodrigo Duterte. But who is really Mayor Duterte? Is he really a good mayor in Davao?
Maayo din siya ngayon. Dahil siya sa mga mayor nga nangagi kanya, ito, kaya namintin niya una ang pace ang atin. Kadwa, ang kwan, ang beautification sa Davao City, na makita na ito na sa People's Park di Butang, ito ang mga park, ipagawa po niya. Kung ato na yung mga dagto, mga investor nga ni-service na kaya sa Davao. Kung upside, limpyo kayo ang Davao, ganahan sa mga turista. Kung wala yung mga krimen na nang tabo. Kaya ng mga pasanan ng mga kidnapping sa sulit sa Davao. Wala ko lang kita anak. Maratang tao, layas na lang sila. Habang si Mayor ang mayor sa Davao.
Tamo as Mayor Duterte kay Mayor Duterte kay good mayor sa Davao. Kaya yung gina-improve ang Davao na dili pareha sa uban nga city. Si Duterte is good siya kasi ginawa niya yung Davao as port safest city. Mayo kay mayor man siya. Mayo siya. Kaya dili siya mayor, di siya ba mayor. Dagkan ang mahimo niya, dagkan. Sa kwan, limpyo ang Davao, peaceful ang Davao, wala yung mga kwan, may mga krimen pero dili gid kwan dili kayo da ako yung mga kwan sulbada da yung may mga krimen.
Diba? Ang Davao kanang ato lain sa pagkakaroon. Sa una is alos ka na, madunggan mo na mga patay sa gisang kalye. Sa pagkakaroon, dila nag-mayor si Duterte, wala na, limpyo na tanan. Sa pananglan, karong gibago man niya ang Davao. Sa panganato ang ako, na ang Davao magpuyo ng malinaon. Diba, diri, sa Davao, dili man tanan, puro mga badlungon. So, unang-una para makatawib sila sa ilang mga bisyo, unang-una patampol ang Diyos para ang Davao mag-school. Diba, dagana tara duga dito sa kawasan nasod. Ang mga trahedya. Ipalangga na sa Ginoo. Abili mo ang Davao, diritanan mga Diyos mo. Kadwa, nangan suportahan na ito na sa plano sa umaabot. Para dili kay kanilang ang Davao, umaabot ang panahon mas kanang inyong kinakita karon mas labuan pa na kung si Duterte ang mahimong president or sa iyang plano sa pagkakaroon. So, mga na siguro. Ang kayuhan ni Duterte na makita na sa mga tao sa Davao.
Si Mayor Duterte ay isang mabait na tao, tapos kwan siya ang pagka-presidente, ay pagka-mayor niya dere is ang iyan leadership yun, kuyaw yun kayo, as in gunit yun niya ang tao yun niya ba, as in kung naapoy mga ang krimen dere sa Davao is little lang yun siya. Dili pareha sa ubang nasod ang krimen high. Kaya nga no, disiplinado siya na tao. Tapos, isa po, kung naamay makitabo na mga dili angay na may tabo, automatic dahil na nga to ang mga kapulisan po na isugo ni Mayor, acto gita yun. Unsa kalahian sa mga nahimong mayor dere, siya ay kuan buutan maitabangon sa mga tao, especially sa atong mga brother and sister na mga Muslim in mga lumads.
Para sa kwa good mayor si Mayor Rodrigo Duterte, kay tungo daghan siyag nahimo ug daghan mga investor ni adto diri sa atong akay. Tungod ang Davao peaceful, then disiplinado, anak lang isa daghan pang daghan pang siya o
kalahian
sa uban ang iyang kalahian sa bangko unsa gyud ang iyang ginapakita. tuman. Dili kay hulga lang iya ka. Dili, yan yung pinapuan. Kasi mga siya babayan mo.
Responsibility, it's a good sense of leadership. You can see it in our city, okay? Like, you can see the people, the streets, it's clean. There are no drug pushers. I mean, like, if there are, those people are already in jail, right? So, yeah, those are my reasons. And I guess, among all the other mayors here in the Philippines, we say that Mayor Duterte is really the best. As a citizen of Davao City, I can say, and I can attest to that Mayor Duterte is a good mayor.
Opinion of the Davao venues, I can say that Mayor Rodrigo Duterte has been able to discharge his duties and administrative functions very well. So therefore I must say, yes, he is a good mayor. Why do you say so? Because it is apparent and ostensible in our city that there are a lot of developments, especially in terms of infrastructure, which is a manifestation that there is really an economic growth. Especially Davao City was known then as a home to, let's say, syndicates and all other lawless elements. And this is a manifestation that upon Rudy Duterte's assumption as mayor of Davao City, these lawless elements and all other deviations of the people from the city government have been gradually eradicated. Therefore, Rudy Duterte is a good leader. But as for my personal perspective, every leader has his good and bad points. On the other hand, when we say bad points, I associate it directly with those charges and the issues as well as the fiascos of his administration, particularly the extrajudicial killings in Davao City. Although, as the local chief executive, he is bound to eradicate and eliminate these issues, yet there are some rumors that behind this extrajudicial killing is the person of Rudy Duterte. But as to the certainty, I cannot yet say, but this is the collective opinion and I must say the voice of the people in terms of this issue. Another bad point that he has exhibited as mayor is that there is the passion for or embracing of torture and physical violence in terms of this accused, where in fact before the law they are still presumed innocent unless otherwise decided by the court of their guilt. So this particular scenario, these bad points that I have cited, are but a mere point of my personal dissent over the collective opinion saying that Rudy Duterte is a good leader.
The question is Mayor Duterte a good mayor? Now we have to qualify that. Word good meaning differently for me as it is for you. When we say good as a person, I have some reservations with the goodness of the man. I do not find any goodness in a man who supports extrajudicial killings and tortures and of the kind. He prides himself to be democratic but his actions and his programs do not reflect them. We may find goodness in his efforts to eradicate, as what Ms. Dugan said, criminality in society, but he has never really succeeded, as no other public official had ever succeeded in eradicating criminality. We could not even compare the administration of Rudy Duterte with the previous administrations because each administration has its own set of problems. It is only during this time where the drug problem was given focus and attention, simply because of the gravity of the situation. So, what about the programs? Okay, I beg to disagree that progress can be a measure of the goodness of a man or of an administration, because it is imperative of a government to really introduce progress, betterment, benefit to his constituents. Any governance or any administration fails in this aspect is a total failure. And then if we could try to compare this with the previous administrations, they also have their own shares of highs in terms of providing for the benefit, progress of society. I am not personally against progress, but what I am against is progress through sacrificing of our basic rights. If you will try to ask local businessmen, they do not really approve of the policies of the mayor, because business-wise, it is really anti-business. The liquor ban at 12 o'clock does not, or in fact, it brings down the profit of businessmen engaged in public nightlife. And then the smoking ordinance. It is worthy to note that this, he said, principal projects of the pet projects of Duterte were not really formulated with the view of public benefit. Those who know him personally would know that this is his own way of getting rid of the vices of which he has engaged himself in, to the detriment of his children. But he has failed on this miserably, because his children has not distanced themselves from the vices. Now, if you say Duterte rules with an iron hand, I beg to disagree. His iron hand is only felt by those cowards who would rather bow down to his demands rather than stand up for their rights. Because people of Davao City might be very careful, wary in bringing firearms. But he had not stopped officials, persons coming from outside the provinces toting their firearms openly in the public. And incidents where that involves outsiders, or city dwellers outside of the city and who are not city residents, who would come to Davao City to create havoc and disorder, has never been placed under the iron hand rule of Duterte. Okay. If goodness is the man, I would say he's good. Theologically, as God had said, he will give man 3 scores and 10 years. He's almost 70. Based on that gift of life from God, then he must be a good man. But he would have been a better man if God would grant him another 10 years of life. That is something to see 10 years from now. Lastly, he does not have a clear, appreciable really programs, platform of government that can be realized. He is always toying with the idea of peace and order, which everyone ends as in peace rather than enjoying order. If there is goodness in the man, then I believe in the goodness of his prophetic words that criminals in the city will die. And every time he says this, criminals do die, 1, 2, 3 criminals a day. And people in the city find joy in keeping track of the increasing number of extrajudicial killings. We have been studying, my students have been studying political theories. He only fits in one, the Machiavellian doctrine. Other than that, all other political theories have never been adopted by Duterte because he believes in the Iron Hand rule, acting as the mayor, but his actuations are that of a prince. If you know what I mean.